So Joe Biden is chalking up endorsements from his one-time rivals in the Democratic presidential race. Just this week, Senator Amy Klobuchar, Mayor Pete Buttigieg, and one of my next guests, former Congressman John Delaney, said that Biden is their pick for president. Some Bernie Sanders supporters think there's a concerted effort, though, within the party to keep him from winning the nomination. With me, two former Democratic candidates, Marianne Williamson and John Delaney, former congressman, of course, Marianne, an author and an activist. We thank you both for being here.
Thank you.
Absolutely. So, Congressman Delaney, you've endorsed Joe Biden. Marianne, you have endorsed Bernie Sanders. Earlier this week, you called endorsements a coup. Now, I know that you backed off of that language, but you did tell Aaron Burnett, and I want to quote this to get this right, "The moderates are consolidating, and it's a huge stop Bernie movement." So just for clarity, are you saying that you believe there is a conspiracy within the Democratic Party to keep Bernie Sanders off the ticket?
We don't need to use a word like conspiracy, but is there a massive effort among certain establishment forces to make sure that Bernie is not the candidate? That's obvious to everybody, I think.
Okay. And what is your response to that, Congressman?
Well, I don't think it's about Bernie. I actually think we believe Joe Biden is the best person to defeat Donald Trump, which is by far the most important thing. He's the best person to walk into the White House and actually be able to govern and get things done for the American people. And I also think he is by far the best person to address the central challenge we have as a nation, which is how divided we are. And he is the person who I think, because he is an individual of such high character, and his campaign has been predicated on this notion of restoring the soul of the nation, he is the person who I think can bring us together. So I tend to think that this is less about, quote, stopping Bernie Sanders. We have two candidates
left, and we're all stepping in and
picking who we think the best person is. And I think we all think Joe Biden, by any measure, is the best person to take on Trump, govern, and actually bring unity back to this country.
So you are saying that there is no degree of hesitation or fear in the Democratic Party that Bernie Sanders, if Bernie Sanders was at the top of this ticket?
Well, I think there's a lot of concern that if Senator Sanders is our nominee, and I think all of us have made it very clear that we'll support the nominee, whoever that is, but that doesn't mean we can't step forward and say we think one of our remaining two candidates is much better at accomplishing the mission, which is beating Donald Trump. There's tremendous concern. I had a big event with some of my former colleagues in the House just last week, where I was catching up with them after my race, and there were dozens of them there. And there's deep concern in the House, in the ranks of the House, particularly those seats that were flipped from Republican to Democratic seats and gave the speakership to Nancy Pelosi, which has been so important to our democracy. There's deep concern that if Senator Sanders is at the top of the ticket, that he won't be the person who can actually give the kind of election results we need, not only to keep the House, but also to flip the Senate. So there is concern about that, of course.
Marianne?
Well, first of all, I certainly agree with John that the important thing for all of us to remember is that either Bernie Sanders or Joe Biden would be an infinitely better president than Donald
Indeed.
Trump. So we all agree about that. But just as John has said that some have a deep concern about Sanders as the nominee, there are others of us who have deep concern about Joe Biden as the nominee. You know, you mentioned healing the soul of America. I literally wrote the book. But you don't heal without naming what's wrong. You have to do some radical truth-telling. And even when you talked about the fact that we won the House back because of all the candidates who actually stood for what the Democratic Party has traditionally stood for. And that is Bernie in the presidential race. The idea of we need more than an alternative to Donald Trump. We need an alternative to the dominant economic and political and social ethos in this country, by which too much wealth and power is concentrated in the hands of a very few people. That ignites passion. We need to ignite passion that is equal in intensity to the passion of this Trump juggernaut and phenomenon. And Bernie does ignite passion. I'm sorry, you know, Biden, I like Joe. He's a good man. He does not ignite this kind of passion. We need more than passion against Trump. We need passion for a new possibility in the United States, which is a return to a more traditional way of really recognizing that in a society where all are deemed equal, all are deemed deserving and having the right to equal opportunity in their lives, that means a fundamental shift back to a time when there was a greater economic economic justice and more people in this country have the opportunity to soar. That is what universal education will give, higher education. That is what universal health care will give. That is all that Bernie Sanders stands for. And people are passionate about the idea of having a greater shot at the American dream.
So, Marianne, let me ask you this. And, Congressman, I promise I'm going to get back to you in a minute. Tomorrow, of course, is International Women's Day. Their theme is An Equal World is an Enabled World. Elizabeth Warren spoke about her frustration with the lack that she has seen on the campaign trail for the support of women. Let's listen to what she said here.
If you say, yeah, there was sexism in this race, everyone says, whiner. And if you say, no, there was no sexism, about a bazillion women think, what planet do you live on? I promise you this, I will have a lot more to say on that subject later on.
Marianne, what do you have to say on that subject? Did you get that same sense when you were on the campaign trail?
Oh, yeah. She's 100% correct. Misogyny is a deeply rooted prejudice inside the consciousness of people. And I'm afraid to say it's deeply rooted in the consciousness of many women as well. We are mocked. We are trivialized. We are diminished, talked about in ways that people would not talk about men. And like I said, unfortunately, that's among too many women as well.
Congressman, there were six women vying for this ticket, for this nomination. There is one left. Technically, Tulsi Gabbard is still in the race, but how essential do you think it is for Vice President or for Biden to choose a female vice president? And who should it be?
Well, listen, it's up for the vice president. First of all, he has to actually win the nomination, which is what we're all focused on. Secondly, he has to make the decision as to who he thinks is in a position to be the president day one, because that's really the decision you make. Has to be someone who gets along well with him, who can be a productive member of his team.
How likely could it be a female?
I certainly would encourage him to choose a woman, because I think it's incredibly important. I think the six women who ran, including my friend Marianne, who's on television here with me, I think it was tremendous, right, that our field represented the beautiful diversity of who we are as a country. We all know we have to do more. I agree entirely with the comments Senator Warren just made. And so I think it would be incredibly important for the Democratic ticket to have as the vice president a woman. I think that's important. That would be my recommendation. But ultimately, of course, it is up to the nominee to choose the person that in their judgment works best on their team. Mm-hmm. You know, just the way President Obama chose Vice President Biden, which obviously turned out to be a tremendously productive
sure.
relationship between the two. And it's got to be someone who could be president. But, you know, I would encourage the team to choose a woman as the vice president. Absolutely.
Marianne, who do you think would best complement Bernie Sanders in the VP seat? And would you volunteer for the job?
And who would be my choice, you say?
Well, would you volunteer for the job?
As John said, that is the decision to be made by the nominee. And I agree with everything that John said. I think having a woman on the ticket is very, very important. And it has to be a woman that the nominee feels he has chemistry with or she has chemistry with. Tulsi will perhaps be on the debate stage. And what's important is that it be someone who represents the diversity. And this diversity, gender diversity, is so important at this time. Mm-hmm. The aspiration to see a woman on that ticket is so great, and I think that whether it's Biden or Bernie, they know that this is going to happen, and we have many good women to choose from, and
right.
It'll be exciting.
Okay, real quickly, I only have a couple of seconds, but Congressman, I wanted to get this from you because people are waiting, of course, to see who Elizabeth Warren endorses. She told the Boston Globe, "Why would I owe anybody an endorsement? Is that a question they asked everybody else who dropped out of the race?" Most likely they did ask everybody else, but despite that, does she have a responsibility, do you think, to endorse anyone?
I don't think she has a responsibility. I mean, listen, I have enormous respect for Senator Warren. And I think she'll do what she thinks is ultimately in the best interest of the Democratic Party. I'm entirely comfortable with that. And she'll make whatever decision she feels at the right moment in time where her voice and her opinions can be heard and be part of the debate and where she can shape the future of this party and the future mm-hmm. of this country. And she'll do that in the Senate. And I suspect she'll do that in this campaign at some point in time.
Marianne Williamson, John Delaney, always a pleasure to have both of you here. Thank you for taking the time for us.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.